In this video, I want to discuss with you about stress control. In this extremely competitive world, especially when you have a corporate job and you are constantly giving targets to meet and you are shouldered with tremendous responsibilities of your company in your workplace, it really becomes extremely difficult to cope up with your day-to-day activities, with your responsibilities as a parent, your responsibilities as a spouse, your responsibilities as a son or whoever you are in that family, if you have a joint family, if more members are living in your family as a brother, as even a cousin or a friend, and your responsibilities as a worker. I thought of this video especially because while I was browsing through and working on a lot of my research work, one of this particular examples came in about, I read a news article about a very young 40-year-old managing director and vice president of a continental company who was very athletic, used to jog 8 to 10 miles a day, which is a lot, and was never drinking, did not have the habit of smoking, and yet at the age of 40, at a very young age of 40, he had achieved a lot of monetary success, very high position in life, but at a very young age died of a sudden heart attack, a tremendous cardiac arrest without any warning. He has two beautiful kids. He left them behind, his wife. Now, the reason behind discussing this story is that what was the reason, you think, that this person died then? Usually with cardiac arrest or heart attacks, we usually relate it with cholesterol. And cholesterol comes when you are eating a lot of stuff you're not supposed to and not giving your body enough exercise. Here in this case, we have an example of a very healthy executive. He's athletic, he's working out, he's doing everything. He has enough money, so there is no stress as far as money is concerned because he's rich, obviously. He's the MD and vice president of a global company, and he's working out, he's taking care of himself, he enjoys his work. Yeah, there were some quotes of his interview, and it said that he was enjoying his work too, and yet he missed out on something. Now, what is this something? The position he was on, and because of that, the amount of work he had to do, probably the days, the hours in a day that he had to catch up with his responsibilities was not enough. So although he found time for himself to work out, be athletic and take care of his physical body and everything, when they did the autopsy, they couldn't really found out anything. But one of the surgeons, the only possible thing he said was, and that he actually deduced when they had interviewed his wife, was that he had difficulty sleeping. What happened in his case was that when he used to sleep, he used to hardly get 4 to 5 hours of sleep a day on an average. Now, an average human being like you and me, we need 7 to 8 hours of sleep. Why? So I went into more research of this, and I realized that when we sleep, we go into two stages. The REM, which is the rapid eye movement stage. When we are sleeping, try to look at a person who is sleeping, and if when they are in the REM state, you will be amazed. You will be frightened actually. I'll try to do this to make this video a little bit exciting. Okay, so it's like, I hope I did it correctly, but this is something that goes on. Now, when this REM state is going on, basically it is mental consolidation. So, which means the brain is fixing itself. There's a lot of things going on with your brain and it is fixing itself. And the non-REM is when you go into your delta state and you are, or into even your theta state, and you are relaxing. But at that time, your physical body is being repaired. A lot of your cells and internal organs are being fixed at that time. So that is the purpose of our sleep. And it's extremely important. Actually, there was something else I want to share. I didn't get a chance to memorize it, but yeah. So there's a fact which says that just one night of sleep loss increases your body toxins drastically. Toxins like interleukin, IL-6, TNF-alpha, and CRP can cause cancer, arthritis, and heart disease. So now you can imagine how much important our sleep is for us. Now, it said also that if you sleep for less than 5 or 6 hours, you are going to be mentally extremely irritable throughout the day due to lack of REM sleep. Similarly, sleep of less than 5 hours will make you a physical mess, even to the extent that you will not be able to control your own motor skills. So, what if this executive had done one small thing or added one small thing in his routine? Stress management, which is extremely important. No doubt that executive took his company to the best level, but he could have done much more. Had he just spared 10 to 15 minutes a day, 3 to 5 minutes, three times a day to control his stress by cleansing his mind of overactive thoughts, by cleansing himself, clearing out his mind and having some peace. And that stress management would have helped him to sleep better. Thank you, my friends, for watching. And I love you. Do not let your life go after money so much, after success so much, that you fail to enjoy the small things of life. The reason behind mostly my sharing these videos is I did that. I really did that for a long time. And there was almost no coming back. But thanks, I am back. So shall you be. I love you.